morning. What is your full name?
My full name is Lavleen Singh.
Where are you from?
I belong to Jalandhar, but currently I am staying in Patiala.
Okay. Do you like this town?
Yes, of course. This is rather my favorite town in the whole of the Punjab.
All right. Can I see your ID?
Yes, sure.
Do you work or are you a student?
Well, I am a working professional as a medical doctor in a good hospital.
Okay, what are your responsibilities there?
Well, I deal in the emergency cases, especially the trauma cases in which the patient arrive in the emergency in a very debilitated condition. So, I take care of them.
Okay. Would you like to work there in the future?
Yes, definitely. Treating the sick and such needy person is my passion, and I have been pursuing this from last 15 years. So, I would love to work in this field in the future also.
Does your job require full concentration?
Yes, it needs a lot of energy, focus and concentration because I have to deal with the lives of people. So it is very crucial for me to work in a good way.
Okay, let's talk about transport. Which is your favorite transport, public or private?
Well, as far as my personal opinion is concerned, I prefer private transport, which is my own car, because it saves a lot of time for me.
Okay. Do you drive?
Yes, I drive it from last time.
Do you want your children to drive in the future?
Yes, of course. Everybody should learn driving because it is an important part and parcel of life.
Alright. Let's talk about your home. Do you live in a house or apartment?
Well, I live in a house, and it is located in Professor Colony in Patiala. Hmm. And currently I am staying in a rented accommodation.
Okay. Is there any improvement you need in your house?
Yes, obviously. I think that my room requires some ventilation more than now. So I have planned for installing some ventilation gadgets over there. And along with that, the paint of the front wall of my room has become somewhat dull, so I have planned to paint it with blue color.
Okay. Which is your favorite room in your house?
Well, my own room is my favorite room. It is located on the first floor on the left side, and I love my room, and I always try my best to keep it clean and tidy.
All right. Okay, let's talk about toys. What was your favorite toy in your childhood?
Well, as far as my memory is concerned, I can recall that a small electronic car was my favorite, which was gifted by my father to me when I was young.
Okay. Do you think toys help in the development of children?
Yes, obviously. Toys and games. These are two important aspects of personality development of any child. Right from the age of 3 years, as far as psychology is concerned, the child starts developing his sense of identity, and when he plays with toys, he comes to know that, like any other object in the world, he has his own unique identity.
Okay, what is the difference between the toys before and toys nowadays?
Well, there is a huge difference in the types and categories and choice of toys which children prefer. These days, electronic gadgets are more popular, like the PlayStations, electronic cars, whereas in the previous periods when technology was not so much advanced, then the people used to play with simple things like only bicycles, small bicycles like toys, and other plastic or rubber balls.
Okay. What is the impact of sharing toys between children?
Well, sharing is a very good quality which should be cultivated right from a young age, and sharing develops a sense of compassion for others, and it also allows to develop a team spirit, because sharing is equal to caring.
Alright, now I'm going to give you your 2 minute topic. Fine. Here is your cue card. This is your paper and pencil. You will have 1 minute to prepare on this topic, and you have to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. I can stop you in between. Fine?
Well, the enforcement of laws in the local area are very mandatory for a well-regulated and flourishing society. And in my opinion, various types of laws should be made, and these should be improved by the authorities from time to time. One of the law which I like the most, I would like to quote that. That recently, the New Delhi government, which is the headquarters and the national capital of India, the chief minister of that state, he made a resolution in the upper house of his local governing body that the vehicles in the New Delhi state should be now, they should come out with a proper orientation of 50-50 rule. This rule was a mere model of the rule copied in New York City, in which the vehicles with the even number, they can come out on 3 days in the week, and the other vehicles with the odd number, they can come out in the other 4 days of the week. In this way, the pollution on the air, it gets very much decreased. Along with that, I think that this law has also managed to increase the green cover by not only reducing the number of vehicles on the road, but also it has allowed the people to become aware regarding the alarming hazardous effects of the air pollution and other types of noise pollution which comes out of the increasing number of vehicles on the road. So I think that other types of modalities, like increasing the number of CNG vehicles which are driven by some types of fuels which do not produce any types of fumes or harmful chemicals, and also by increasing the public types of vehicles for transportation. These are the methods in which such laws should be enforced by the authorities. And it was a really good experience when I visited last year New Delhi, and I saw this rule was managed in the local state in a very good way. And now I think that this law should be made mandatory by even the national governments, so as to regulate it in the whole of the country, because every society needs a pollution-free environment. So, on the whole, I can say that it was a really memorable experience, and this example was also quoted by the BBC documentary channel, in which they said that India has really made a appreciable effort in reducing the worldwide global warming by reducing the number of hydrofluorocarbons in the air.
Can I have paper pencil back?
Yes, sure.
Okay, now I'm going to ask you a few questions related to this topic, right?
Yes.
What international law should be applied all over the world?
Well, in my opinion, the world is suffering from huge amounts of wastage of plastic goods. So I think that internationally, in the consumer courts as well as in the United Nations court, such a enforcement and law should be passed that the production of plastic goods, especially the non-recyclable, non-biodegradable category of plastic, should be discouraged. And it should be the role of every government of every country to regulate it in its own area.
All right. Are policemen popular in your country?
Yes, of course. The policemen are quite popular. And recently, the Lady Singham, who is popularly known as a copy of the great Bollywood movie, she is quite popular these days because she is quite brave, and she has done many heroic things in regulating the law in the local area. Such events usually occur in which the policemen play a crucial role in maintaining peace and tranquility in the area.
All right. Who are more popular in your country, lawyers or the police?
Well, both hold equal position in my opinion, because they have different types of duties in the society. Depending upon their part, on one side where the policemen are concerned in the field and in patrolling and maintaining a good environment in the regarding law and order, while on the other hand, the lawyers are more concerned about the legal issues in the courts, both at the international level as well as the national levels. So I think that both the posts of these authorities are equally important for the society.
Okay. What kind of laws you think should be implemented in future?
Well, in future, I think that cyber crime should be decreased, and for that purpose, internationally, the great leaders should sit together at the good summits which are organized annually, sometimes by the United Nations or by also the seven combined nations like the Soviet Union. So these things are quite increasing, no doubt. But on the whole, it is quite evident that the pace at which technology is increasing, the cyber crimes are increasing at an alarming rate, which need a good check. So international laws and regulations should be made in this regard.
All right. This is the end of your speaking. Thank you.